Welcome to Enoch's Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we start making a tailstock die holder. But not any tailstock die holder. This die holder has the facility for the die to rotate when it hits a face, which is very useful when you're cutting threads in the lathe. Not going to worry about that die hitting the face, smashing the die up or breaking something. You can take it easy and relax. As the die hits the face, it automatically starts to revolve and stop cutting. So there's no pressure to stop the machine in time. The die holder is made from a kit by Hemingway. I've put the details at the beginning of the video on the descriptions page. So let's go into the workshop and see how we make it. Now let's say that you want to cut a thread on the end of this 6mm bar. Most people would use a die in a die holder, but in the lathe, the first problem you have is you need to get the die holder square to the end of the shaft. Easy way of doing that is bringing the tailstock in, holding the die on the end of the tailstock, wind the tailstock in, and that will present the die square to the workpiece. Now if you wanted to use the lathe to cut the thread using the die, you could turn the motor on slow and this would feed along, but the problem is when you get to the end, the die will lock up on the end where the diameter changes and this will spin, and what normally happens is you probably
damage one of the handles on your die stock
before you could stop the lathe.
With the standard tailstock die holder,
normally you have some sort of guide bar
which holds on the tailstock.
Then you have a die holder which runs on this bar. So that presents the die, which goes in the end, square to the bar. And on this one, I can use a handle for turning the die. Also, you can use the motor on the lathe to run it down to the face. But once again, once you hit that face, the die will lock up, this will spin round, hit your lathe. So to overcome that, you need
a die holder that will spin when the die hits the face, and that's what we're making today. This is what you get in the kit: a set of steel blanks, a number 2 Morse taper, and a set of screws for the project. And on the right you have the drawings and a detailed list on how to machine the parts. The first step is to hold the blank in a 4-jaw chuck and face all the blanks off on one end. Place the blank for the clutch cone in the chuck, leaving a gap at the back so you can get a micrometer or a caliper in to measure the width.
I can just get a micrometer down the back. 8.12.5.
Centre drill, then drill a hole to get a board and bar in.
Should be a 1-inch hole reamed, but I haven't got a 1-inch reamer, so I'll bore this out to 1-inch. .395.
The next job is to set the compound slide to 30 degrees.
And start to bore the taper. Just using some fine emery.
The thickness of the lip on the end should be 14 thou. Use a caliper to give you an idea of the thickness.
Next blank in there, I've left the compound slide at 30 degrees.
Now I'll just machine this part exactly the same to make a second cone.
These are the two cones that I've machined. All that needs to be done with those is to go onto the milling machine, put the slot in the back.
We now move on to the 1-inch die holder, item 2. I've just placed the blank in the forge or chuck,
and I've just set it up so it's running true. That's running about a thou. Each 10 marks is a thou. I'll have to check my dies first before I bore the finished size. And I'll turn this diameter down just to give me a concentric diameter. I'll change my tool for a smaller tool. Now I need to turn this end down 1 7/16 by 3/8 long. I've set up my boring bar and I'm just boring this hole out. I drilled it out to a 1/2 inch. It needs to be 0.625, which is 5/8. I don't have a 5/8 reamer, so I'm just boring it out. This is the rod that has to fit through the hole. I'm using that as a gauge. I reckon I've got about 5 thou left. As my lathe's metric, most of my equipment is metric, reamers, drills. So when it comes to imperial, I'm having to convert between the two. That's a tight fit in there. This is the bar that has to run in. I'll just put the tool through again without adjusting any cut.
I'll now make the bore to hold the die.
I've got a selection of dies from different manufacturers. And that one fits. This is a solid. That fits easy. Another solid one. Yeah. And a split one. These all fit. It's 0.973. Supposed to be 1-inch bore. The dies all fit.
Now I have to take this out, turn it around and hold it on the outside diameter that I've just machined. I've set the bore running true using the end of the inner bore.
The compound slide is still set at 30 degrees from the original tape as I cut on the cone. Now I wanted to match a 30 degree on here. Well, if the tool was in the normal position, which would be this side, the 30 degree would be going into the part rather than coming out this end.
So to overcome that, I've had to reverse the tool in the tool holder, turn it upside down, put it on centre line, and now I'm cutting on the back, but the lathe is still turning the normal way because on the Boxford the chuck is a screw-on chuck, and if I reversed it with the tool at the back, there's a chance that the chuck could unscrew.
So what I've done is I'm still cutting the same
30 degree angle.
The chuck's still moving in the same direction, but I'm cutting on the back with the tool upside down. So let's see how that goes.
I'll finish turning that until the small end of the cone gets to 1-inch diameter and machine a 0.826 bore so I can cut a thread at 1 millimeter pitch. The bore's now ready to have the thread cut. I've changed the gears to give a 1 millimeter pitch.
So to set the tool up, I've just put all this in the tool holder. I'm going to check that it's square. I'm resting it on the edge of the tool and checking that it's square to the face of the part. Now I just need to check that if I go in there and go into the depth, that's touched the face and I'm clear.
So how do you know when your screw cutting tool,
especially in a bore, is coming up to the face? What I've done is set my dial indicator up in a block that's clamped to the bed. I can slide this along
to set the distance I need to travel.
And what happens is, well, the saddle comes along, and use the dial indicator to tell you when you're at the end of the thread. So what I do is give it one full rev and stop it at zero. Put the machine into reverse. Back to the start.
I'll put some marking blue in the bore and now we'll cut the thread. Now I've engaged it, I'll leave the half nuts engaged when I reverse. I just need to stop before I hit the face. Now I've taken the tool to the full depth, so that should be the finished thread. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful. Hope it's interesting. We'll continue this next time on eKnots Engineering.